So this is a young kid, probably 14 or 15 years old, who was at school and jumped out of the chair onto the floor. So maybe just a 2 foot fall onto his ankle, and obviously he felt a snap, a pop, a crack, whatever you want to call it. Was having a lot of pain on his left ankle. You can see there's some swelling there, but no gross angulation or doesn't appear to be dislocated. Let's go ahead and look at the next picture. This is from the lateral side, and you can see there's a lot of swelling right about here. But there's no ecchymosis. Ecchymosis is when there's a purplish discoloration from blood on the subcutaneous tissue, and it does not appear to be dislocated. So let's look at the actual x-rays. You can see that there's two breaks right there, and I'm going to make it really obvious for you. This little chip right here should be right about here, and you can see that this bone right here, kind of going like that, should have matched these other pieces right here. So let me undo all that. So not only is there a fracture, but you can see that the whole bones are kind of pushed this way. That is called displacement, or a subluxation of the ankle joint itself. Let's go ahead and look at the lateral film. When this is the lateral film, you can see that the bones are pushed out this way. You can see that fragment right there that we were talking about before. That is almost like an avulsion type fracture. You can see that the tibia, which is this long bone right here, is pushed forward compared to the rest of the foot. This is actually a different patient, I'm sorry. So you can see the fracture there. This is the growth plate. This is getting pushed that way, all the swelling. The fibula here broken. So you got the tibia, you got fibula, and the break there. And this is a lateral view. This is actually a different ankle, but the same kind of injury. A tibia and fibular fracture with a little bit of displacement. This one's also displaced. So this kid we put under sedation, and we basically pulled on the ankle and then put opposite pressure to where the angulation was at. And this is the x-ray after the reduction. If you want to look again how it looked before and how it looked after the reduction, it's a lot better aligned. It's not completely aligned, but it's good enough. Probably that he won't need anything else done on this. Is another film of the same one. And then we put a splint on him. And we put a posterior splint with something called a sugar tongue. We call that the combination of the two, the Cadillac of splints, because it really immobilizes well the lower extremity. Of course, he's given crutches and pain medicine. Follow up with the orthopedic surgeon, who will decide then what kind of treatment he needs long term, whether it be surgery, whether it be a walking boot, whether it be a whole leg cast or partial leg cast, and so on. So this is a fracture dislocation of the ankle involved with the tibia and fibula. This other name for it will be a bimalleolar fracture of the ankle. And then I have some other pictures here, not that same patient, but I just want to put it in, talk about ankle fractures in general. This one's after we were splinted, some other patient. Look at this one here. This one has a fracture. You can see the fragment here. You can see another fracture line there, and the fibula broken right here. So let's see, this other film is the same ankle, but now on the lateral view, you can see the displacement there, you can see the fragments there and there. All right, I hope you learned something, and I'll keep doing these kinds of videos. Please send any suggestions or comments. Bye-bye.